Hi, welcome to lesson 6 of our bridge lessons. We're going to continue with searching for a fit, and we're looking at the responder bidding. So that's when your partner opens one of a suit and you want to try and find a fit. So a couple of principles. The first one is you always bid your longest suit first if you have two suits of unequal length. And when we say a suit, it has to have at least four cards to be something you can bid on your own. If you have equal length suits, if they are both four card suits, you bid up the line as we've shown you before. So that means you bid hearts before spades, or diamonds before hearts, or diamonds before spades. So you bid the lower ranking suit first. If you have two five-card suits, then you bid the higher ranking suit first. So you bid it the opposite way around. And I'll show you some examples here. The other principle is that when you want to bid a new suit at the two level, so this is your own suit and you need to go to the level of two to bid it, you need at least 10 high card points. And because it's a new suit, it is also unlimited, so you're not showing a top of your point range, and it's forcing, meaning your partner has to bid. Your partner cannot pass. And your suit has to have at least four cards in it to bid on the two level, or to bid a suit at any level for that matter. Right, we're going to go through some examples. So this is the first one. You have seven high card points here. If your partner opens the bidding with one spade, the question is, what do you respond? Because you only have 7 points, you do have two suits there, but you cannot bid a suit on the two level. To bid clubs or diamonds, you have to go to the two level because the bidding is at one spade. You can't do that. So because you have at least 6 high card points, you have to respond, and you would bid one no trump, which shows between 6 and 9 high card points and no fit. And your one no trump bid is not forcing. Your partner can pass. Right, next question is, what if instead your partner had opened one heart? What would you respond? You can pause the video. I hope you said you would respond two hearts. You have the same 7 high card points. You have a fit in hearts because your partner has promised at least 5 of them. And you have an extra point for your doubleton. That gets you to 8 total points. And when you're bidding an old suit, so your partner bid hearts, you're bidding hearts, you show your point range, and you're showing 6 to 9 total points, so you bid two hearts. And that is not forcing, and it's a limited raise. Your partner can pass. What if your partner opened one diamond instead? You could raise to you would bid one no trump, because your partner's showing at least 3 diamonds. You don't know if you have a fit. And you can't bid your clubs on the two level. You don't have enough points, so you bid one no trump, showing 6 to 9 total points and no fit. And if your partner opened one club, again, they could have only 3 clubs. You can bid one diamond now, because you can bid a new suit on the one level. You have enough points for that. And because you've bid a new suit, you're showing 6 points or more. It is forcing, and your partner has to bid when it comes around to him. Here's the next example. You have 8 high card points. Your partner opens one spade. You would like to bid your hearts, but you don't have enough points to go to the two level to bid your hearts. So you would need to bid one no trump, showing no fit and 6 to 9 points. If your partner opened one heart instead, what would you bid? You can pause the video. I hope you bid 3 hearts. You have a heart fit, so you can add on 3 points for your singleton. It gets you to 11 total points. And with 11 total points, you are inviting your partner to game. So you bid 3 hearts. And if your partner has enough points, he will go on and bid 4 hearts, which is game. If your partner opened one diamond instead, now you're able to bid one heart and show your heart suit because it's on the one level. And if your partner opened one club, as we told you in the beginning, if you have two suits to bid, you bid your longer suit first, so you would respond one heart. Next example. here you have 13 high card points. If your partner opens the bidding one spade, you would like to bid one of your suits, and you do have enough points to bid a new suit on the two level. And remembering what we told you about bidding four card suits, you have two equal length suits and they're both four cards. You bid them up the line. That means you bid the cheapest suit first. So the first one you get, your partner opened one spade, the next level above that is one no trump, the next level above that is two clubs, so you would bid two clubs. If instead your partner had opened one heart, you have 13 high card points plus a singleton because you now have a fit in hearts, so you would bid game, four hearts. If your partner opened one diamond, you want to bid one of your four card suits, you bid up the line again, so the next suit above diamonds is hearts, you would bid one heart. And finally, if your partner opened one club, you again would bid one heart. You, even if you don't know if you have a fit in clubs, but you still are looking for a fit in a major in preference to a fit in a minor. So you bid one heart, it's unlimited, shows 6 points at least, and it's forcing your partner has to bid again. Here's a different example, a different hand. It has 15 high card points. If your partner opens one spade, you can see you have two suits to bid. They're unequal length. You want to bid your longest suit first. You can bid hearts on the two level because you have enough points. You have at least 10, so you would bid two hearts. If your partner opened one heart, you can see you have a heart fit and you have game points. You would bid four hearts. If your partner opened one diamond, you would bid your longest suit first, so you would bid one heart, which shows at least 6 points, and it's not limited, and it's forcing your partner has to bid again. And if your partner opened one club, you would bid one heart because you're looking for a fit in a major. This example, you have 12 high card points. If your partner opens one spade, you do have enough points to bid a new suit on the two level, and you will notice that you have two equal length five card suits. When this happens, you always bid your higher ranked suit first. So after one spade, you would bid two hearts. Later on, you may bid your clubs, and because you bid your hearts first, your partner would know that either your hearts are longer than your clubs or they're equal length and five cards, not four cards. If your partner opened the bidding one heart, you would count up your total points and realize you have enough for game, and you would bid four hearts. If your partner opened the bidding one diamond, you bid your higher ranked suit first and bid one heart. And if your partner opened the bidding one club, you again are looking, even though you know you have a fit in clubs because your partner's shown at least three, you still would prefer to find a fit in a major, being hearts. You will still bid one heart, trying to find a heart fit and game in hearts. So you'll bid one heart. So that's all about, just all about searching for a fit in the bidding. So to remember, you always bid your longest suit first when you're responding. When you have equal length suits, you bid four card suits up the line. That means you bid the lower rankings, well, you bid the cheapest bid first, and bid five card suits the opposite way around, so the higher ranking suit first. And when you're responding with a new suit at the two level, you do need at least 10 high card points. Right. Something new. We haven't discussed an opening one note trump bid. This is new information. This is when you are opening the bidding, so you're the first person to bid. If you open with one note trump, what you're telling your partner is you have a balanced hand and 15 to 17 high card points. So 15, 16, or 17. And a balanced hand, as we learned last time, means at most you have one doubleton. You do not have any singletons and you do not have any voids. A little bit of card play. This is for the declarer. So if you are playing the hand and you have a dummy, we're going to teach you about playing towards your honors. So here on the bottom is your suit. You've got the 6, 5, and 3 of hearts, and your dummy has two honors. And the two. The first question is, pause the video and think about how many tricks do you think you can take in hearts with this holding? The answer is that you may be able to take two tricks if you play it correctly. So what we're telling you here is you play towards honors. That means you want to start in your hand and lead cards towards a hand that has the honors or the high cards. And we'll show you how that works. So here you lead a small one. Either east or west has the ace. You don't know which, but you are hoping it's with west, and we'll show you why. So west is second hand. He's going to play low. You play one of your honors, and it holds and it makes the trick. So you win that trick. You need to try and get back into your hand in another suit, and then you will lead hearts again. So you lead a small heart. In this hand, west does have the ace, which is good for us, and he takes it. And now you are going to play your low one, and east-west are going to win that trick. And later on in the play, if you get back into your hand or into dummy, you can play your queen of hearts, because that's now the highest heart. And you have made two tricks in hearts because you played towards your honors. Let's look at what happens if you don't play towards your honors. So let's say you are in dummy now and you decide to play one of your honors because you decide you've got to lose to the ace anyway, so it doesn't matter. So right, so you play your king of hearts, and we now know that west has the ace, and he's going to win it with the ace. They win that trick. Later on, you can play towards your queen, and you will win that trick. And then when you play the last round of hearts, you'll see that you lose that last trick to the jack, and you have only won one out of the three heart tricks, even though the ace was still with west. So when you do have a holding with honors in one hand and not in the other, you want to hope that, and you're missing the ace, you want to hope that the ace is sitting before the hand with the honors, and you want to play towards the hand with the honors, so that when the ace gets played, you can play a little one from your holding that has the high cards. That is the end of our lesson for this week. Join us again next time.